Hey guys, today I wanted to talk about the Real Clear Politics No Toss-Up map for the 2020 presidential election, in which they have recently released right here. This is basically their electoral map without any swing states or likely or lean states. Basically, each state either goes to Joe Biden or it goes to Donald Trump, and they project Biden winning 352 electoral votes and Trump winning 186. Now, this is different from their RCP just electoral map here, which they do use lean states, lean states and likely states, as you can see here. RCP does tend to be very safe with their projections. So, you know, states like Oregon are only lean for Biden. And, you know, states in the Deep South are only likely for Donald Trump. So, you know, they are very cautious when using solid states for either candidate. As you can see, you know, Biden really only has five or six solid states on this map, when really I think, you know, states like Colorado, New Mexico, Oregon, Washington, as well as Connecticut and Rhode Island, I think these are all very safe states for Joe Biden. But of course, RCP likes to be a little safe with the projections, which is why some of these states are not as safe as they tend to be on other forecasts. So on this no toss-up map right here, they do give Joe Biden the presidency with 352 electoral votes, about 15 electoral votes down from Barack Obama's 2008 landslide victory. And right here, I think Joe Biden will actually carry the states of Georgia and the 2nd District of Maine. So I think Joe Biden will be able to tie Barack Obama's victory in 2008, winning 369 electoral votes, I believe. So I think this is all looking very good for Joe Biden. Of course, RCP gives Joe Biden the crucial states of Wisconsin, Michigan, and Pennsylvania, as well as the states of Arizona, Florida, and North Carolina. So these are the three states in which Biden has flipped according to this map, in addition to Nebraska's 2nd District, which Trump carried in 2016. Donald Trump has not flipped any states. He carries only the states that he carried in 2016, minus the six states we just talked about. And looking down here, this is all of the changes in which have occurred on this map, as well as here the electoral spread for either candidate, basically how much they project each candidate to be ahead by. So as you can see, Joe Biden has always been set to win the election. And looking down here, they have their polling averages for each of these swing states. Biden plus 6 in Wisconsin, 8 in Michigan, 2 in Ohio, 7 in Pennsylvania, and we can go all the way down to this list. And if you look at just how many states that Biden is actually pulling ahead by, that Clinton lost 2016, look at these states of Florida and Georgia. Both states that Trump won in 2016, but Biden is now leading in. States of Iowa, Missouri, these are Trump will actually continue to carry these states. But, you know, states like Nevada, Trump was pulling ahead in this state. But, you know, Biden kind of leads in the state of Nevada at the moment. And then we can also compare this to the 2016, 2012, and 2008 data. So Biden, of course, is underperforming in the state of Wisconsin compared to Obama's two electoral victories in 2008 and 2012. He is underperforming in the state of Michigan as well. Of course, the Rust Belt is becoming more and more conservative. However, it's not quite there yet for the Republicans to take. Looking at the state of Ohio, he also underperforms compared to Barack Obama. In the state of Pennsylvania, he actually overperforms Obama's 2012 margin. In the state of Florida, Joe Biden is overperforming any candidate in the past three elections. He leads by 7 points. Look at how close the state of Florida has been, 2.8%, 0.9%. And then 1.2%. The state of Florida is polling very well for Joe Biden. And, you know, I think the state of Florida polling by 7% in favor of Joe Biden is the biggest shock in the polling so far. Looking at the state of Georgia, Trump currently leads by 2.7%, a state in which Barack Obama or Hillary Clinton did not win any time. In the state of North Carolina, this state was lost by Barack Obama in 2012 to Mitt Romney by 2%. However, Biden leads in the state by 2% at the moment. New Hampshire, he polled a little worse than Obama both times. However, you know, definitely crushing Clinton's victory, margin victory in 2016. Looking at the state of Iowa, Trump leads by 1.5%. A state that, you know, Obama won by 9% in 2008, 5% in 2012. So I think Iowa will actually go to Trump just because of, you know, I think it has flipped to the Republican Party by now. Nevada and Arizona, both leading in favor of Joe Biden. Looking at the state of Arizona, it went to McCain by 8.5%, Romney by 9.1%. So he is outperforming Obama in the state of Arizona, as well as in the state of Nevada. He is pulling a little behind Barack Obama's 2008 or 2012 victories. And so that is it for their no toss-up states. And if we actually plotted this on this map, this is how it looks when it's enlarged. As you can see here, Joe Biden does not even need to win the states of North Carolina, Florida, or Ohio. All he needs are these three Rust Belt states, or Arizona, if he doesn't, win one of them. So basically, he can win Wisconsin, Pennsylvania, or Arizona, and then or he can win Michigan and not win Wisconsin. But I think that the most likely worst case scenario for Joe Biden, if he were to significantly underperform, I think he will win the states of Michigan, Pennsylvania, Arizona, and Florida if he were to do his worst. And then, I think Trump would win Wisconsin, Ohio, and North Carolina in Biden's doomsday scenario, and he would still win the election. So, currently this map is looking very good for Joe Biden, 352 electoral votes. So, like I say a lot, I think this is still Joe Biden's election to lose. And I will be having an election night coming out soon, so make sure you watch out for that. And so, if you enjoyed this video, please leave a like as well as subscribing to my channel, and I will see you in the next video.